Hey Xiaomi, where are my updates? Hey OnePlus, where are my updates? Hey Samsung, where are my updates? So you know what? I bought that Xiaomi Redmi Note 4X phone, you know? It's an Android phone, it comes with MIUI pre-installed. It's Xiaomi's custom ROM of Android, like the skin on top of Android. And you know what? I got like one update to like MIUI 8.1 and stuff, but then nothing. Okay, so I mean, the Redmi Note 4X, I think it gets some updates. I mean, it could get an update to Android Oreo, but I didn't just sit with my hands down and hope for the best. No, I installed a custom ROM, Pixel Experience, namely on my Redmi Note 4X. I am thinking of changing to Lineage OS, which seems better. I mean, they are both stock looking ROMs, and they have that stock feel, and they don't really have any additional features or any skin on top of Android, so I really like them. I really like the stock look and feel, and that's why I installed that custom ROM. But custom ROMs come with some really important drawbacks. First of all, in order to update to another version, I mean, you have to go to TWRP, flash it again and all that stuff, and delete system, Dalvik cast and cast, and I mean, all that stuff is like tiring and stuff. I like doing them. I want to be a programmer when I get older, but I mean, that's me, that's not all of the smartphone market. So why are Android updates so late to phones from other manufacturers than Google? Even Google doesn't update the Nexus 6P, if I'm right, but whatever. So yeah, it is because they don't care. Okay, they don't care, and you knew that, but I'm gonna tell you why. Because they already gave you what they wanted. You know, if you get a Xiaomi Redmi Note 4X, you get the full package, you get all the features that Xiaomi wanted to put into MIUI. And I mean, you don't really miss on that much stuff from Android P if you don't get it. I mean, they will just adjust the skin of another Android version and give you all the features you need. But we're talking about security patches here and not really for features. And you know what? Security patches, I mean, they all talk about it, and it's true, security patches could help you like being more secure and have less vulnerability on your phone, but to be honest, I don't think there's a real problem here. I mean, if you like do something that infects your phone with malware, I don't think the security patches will do anything. Or even if the security patches are other stuff, like for security on your phone and, you know, your fingerprint sensor data and the facial recognition data. I mean, Google, who just makes Android themselves, they are not the company to trust these days with your information. So even if they do these things in security patches, you know, storing locally fingerprints and facial recognition like data, I don't think you can trust Google on that. So I mean, what's the real benefit of going to the most recent version of Android? I'll tell you what it is: efficiency and app compatibility. Okay, so when a new version of Android gets released, some bugs are fixed, and you know, the code is written more efficiently in the most recent version, so that's a benefit you get. And also, as I said, you get that app compatibility, because you know, developers tend to drop compatibility for like Android phones that are 5, 6, or 7 years old. And okay, that's partly because the apps that they make are more compatible with the operating system that Google now delivers, but it's also to persuade you to get another phone, to go buy another Android phone. So yeah, is Apple better in this kind of thing? Yes, Apple is better because, you know, they deliver updates to devices that are like, what, 4 or 5 years old? But to be honest here, Apple doesn't have any other manufacturers putting their OS on their phones. They are only themselves. So if they didn't do that, if they didn't provide updates, you know, iOS users would miss out on features and stuff. But if we're talking about Android, you don't really miss out on any features, because if the company really wants to push an update with features that are useful for the phone that you have, they will do it, and they will do it without like going to another version of Android, just another version of the scheme. So that's what I'm telling you here, that Apple is a standalone company with no other manufacturers getting their OS. So in reality, if all these phones from different manufacturers got that Android updates that we all really want, it would be a huge, huge cost for the companies that provide the Android world with budget phones to maintain that. So I guess I'll leave with custom ROMs now, and whoever doesn't know how to do that, maybe I'll make a tutorial. If you want to do that, if you want me to do that, drop a comment down below. And that was the end talk for today, guys. If you like this video, drop a like down below. If you want to tell me something, comment and subscribe for other videos like this. England plays today, so I gotta go. See you on the next one. Peace.